would you do this for me? I'm not asking you to be a team again. If you guys don't get along, all right. It's just one shot. One last show. Once you get an exposure like this, Alpha 7 will beg me to sign you up. Jesus, what's it gonna look like when I go back to the office and I couldn't even make a deal with my own uncle?
My personal opinion, lousy.
Do you really hate Al Lewis that much?
I don't even discuss Al Lewis anymore.
Oh, we're gonna discuss Al Lewis. Doctor, I gotta tell CBS no, I'm gonna give him a real good answer. You haven't seen him in what, 10 years?
11 years.
You mean to tell me you haven't spoken to him in 11 years?
No, I haven't seen him in 11 years, I haven't spoken to him in 12.
You mean you saw him for an entire year that you didn't speak to him?
It wasn't easy. I sneaked around backstage, so I...
But you spoke to him on stage.
Not to him. Not to him. If he was playing the trap, spoke to the trap. If he was playing the gypsy, I spoke to the gypsy. To him, I didn't speak.
I can't believe that.
Believe it. I can show you witnesses saw me not speaking to him.
It's been 11 years. Has nothing changed for you in 11 years?
Yeah, even 11 years more.
Why?
Why did you ever meet him?
Yeah, I met him when I was 15, once backstage at Madison Square Garden, and once again, backstage at some TV show. He seemed nice enough to me.
No, that's only twice. You had him even three times to hate.
Can I make a suggestion?
Just to give me the finger.
The what?
The finger! On stage, he poked me in the chest with his finger. I'm talking to you, doctor. This has been a hurt, doesn't it? How'd you like to have that 43 years, I had a black and blue hole in my chest. My wife, during dying, they thought I had a tattoo. Telling the man I had the sharpest finger in showbiz.
There's got to be something you're not telling me. You don't work with a man for 43 years without some bond of affection.
Oh, you do. You want other things? You want something else? You spit on me. On stage, you spit in my face.
Oh,
well, shit, if I could work enough spit up, I'd show you.
So he would just stand on stage and spit.
You think he was stupid? He worked in the movie? Yeah. He was standing with his nose on top of mine and purposely saying words start with a T. Talking on the telephone, typing on the typewriter. Touch you on, swear to God, sometimes I thought I'd drown. Can you drink water all day, just saving it up for the night.
I put it in the contract and he spits, he doesn't get paid.
If he had a chance to spit on me again, he wouldn't want to get paid.
Well, answer me this. If it was so bad for 43 years, why did you stay together?
Because he was terrific, that's why. There'll never be another one like him. There's never be another, no one could time a joke the way he could time a joke. No one could do a lie. I mean, I knew what he was thinking. He knew what I was thinking. We're like one person. They said, no, Al Lewis was the best, you understand?
I understand.
As an actor, nobody could touch him. As a human being, nobody wanted to touch him.
So what do I tell CBS?
You know, the last time we worked together?
11 years ago?
11 years ago on the Ed Sullivan Show, July 27th. We did the doctor and the tax collector sketch. You never saw it, did you?
No, but I heard it's wonderful.
About a classic. A classic, a dead man watching that sketch would laugh. I'll tell you, we must have done it 8,000 times, man. It never missed. It never missed. It was, except that night it missed. I don't know what in the hell happened. He was sick or something. His timing was off. He still got a lot of applause. I mean, Ed Sullivan must have said five times, how about that? And later in the first night, he takes off his makeup, puts on his suit, and he says, well, I'm a soul, same to you, I'm retired. I said, what the hell are you talking about? It's 8 o'clock. Let's get something to eat. He says, no, not tonight. I'm retiring for what's left of the rest of my life. He put on his hat, coat, walked out the door, became a stockbroker. And I'm left with an act where I ask questions, there ain't nobody there to answer. I've seen the man to this day. He wrote letters, I tore him up, called. I wouldn't answer the damn phone. Telegram's probably still outside the door.
With all due respect, Uncle Willie, you guys weren't working that much anymore, and maybe he was tired of doing the same thing for 43 years. A man has the right to retire when he wants to, doesn't he?
Not him! Damn it, not him. Don't forget when he retired himself. He retired me too. And damn it, I wasn't ready to retire. Now, for $5,000, he wants to come crawling back. Well, hell with him. I'm single now.
I talked to Al Lewis on the phone, and he's not even interested in the money. He wants to do it for old times' sake.
Yeah,
for his grandchildren, who never got a chance to see him.
Yeah, probably retired broke from the stock market. They never get spit on.
You know his wife died 2 years ago? that he's living in Jersey somewhere with his daughter. He doesn't do anything. He's got arthritis. He's got asthma. He's got poor blood circulation.
I'll send him a pump. Believe me, he'll outlive you.
He very much wants to do this show, Willie.
With arthritis, instead of a finger, he'll poke me with a cane.
CBS wants to do the doctor sketch. And Al Lewis says that he can get up on stage tonight and do that sketch letter perfect without any rehearsal.
I don't even want to discuss it. In the second place, I wouldn't think of doing it without a rehearsal.
Well, then will you agree to this? Let me set up one rehearsal. If it doesn't work out, we'll cancel the whole thing.
I don't trust him. I don't trust him. I think he'll rehearse all week, then walk out on me the night of the show.
Let me see if I can't get him on the phone. I can set something up for Monday.
Wait a minute. I gotta think about it.
Well, we don't have much time, CBS. What are you here?
What are they doing? Going out of business?
I'm dying.
60-40. I get $6,000, he gets $4,000. What the hell's he gonna buy in New Jersey anyway?
I can't do that.
Yeah, you gotta tell him I'm against it. Tell him I'll do it, but with an against it.
It's raining.
He's gotta come here. I'm not gonna go there.
I told him I'd be home. I'm gonna call about one. Hello, Mr. Lewis. Ben Silverman. Fine, thanks. I'm with him here now.
Willie Clark, I left on the other cell phone, so I asked if he remembers that.
That's all right, Mr. Lewis. Actually, Uncle Willie said yes.
With an yes, don't forget the yes.
Now, he's very anxious to do this.
I'm not anxious, you lies, I'm against it. Tally! That'll be
fine. Can we set something up for Monday? In the morning? About 11 o'clock? How far is the drive? About 2 hours?
Make it 9 o'clock.
Be reasonable. On Monday morning at 11 is just fine. Can you give me your address so I can send the contract?
Tell him if he starts with the cloaking and the spitting, I'm taking him to court. The man walks in backstage. Tell him.
Was that in Davenport, New Jersey?
And I don't want any toy turtles talking on the telephone.
Tell him! Tell him! Tell him! When did you decide this?
I decided when you asked.
No, you didn't. You told me you would do it.
It was a bad decision. This is a good one.
Paul, I'm sorry. You have to do it. I've already told CBS that we're rehearsing this week. And more importantly, that man is on his way over here. And I'm not telling him. You told him to call it off.
We'll leave a note outside the door.
We're not leaving any notes. See, this is why I came over here. I thought you were trying to do something like this. I'm going to stay here until I think you two are acting like civilized human beings. And when you're ready to rehearse, I'm going to leave you alone. Is that understood?
Anyway, he's late. He's coming late on purpose just to irritate me.
He's not late. Now listen, Uncle Willie. You're not backing out of this. I don't care what kind of excuses you give. You're not backing out of this. Now just stop it and behave yourself.
What do you mean behave yourself? What the hell you think you're talking to, Amanda and Jackie?
Amanda and Michael. And I wish I was. At least I could reason with them. Now I'm getting chest pains on Monday.
I was up at 8 o'clock, all dressed, ready to go.
So why didn't you shave?
Give me a shit from her so I'll shave. Oh, jeez. I really think I got hepatitis. I'm turning all green.
You don't know what hepatitis is, and you turn yellow from hepatitis, not green.
Maybe I got a bad case.
Now you got me worried. What if he's sick? Maybe I should call him.
You believe he's sick, but not me? Why don't you be his nephew?
That's him. Do you want me to get
him? I didn't hear anything.
All right, now, speaking easy, just put him
on the feel like a pop.
Mr. Lewis. We actually met before a long time ago. My father took me backstage to some theater. I forget the theater.
I remember that my 15, 20 years ago. Backstage.
That's right.
Forget the theater.
Well, come in. Uncle Willie's making some tea. Can I take it?
Thank you.
Yes. Did you have any trouble getting in from Jersey?
My daughter drove.
Oh, that's nice.
1972 Chrysler Black.
The Chrysler's a wonderful car.
Yeah, big one. The Imperial.
Well, I know, I drove it.
You drove my daughter's car?
No, the big Chrysler Imperial. I rented one when I went to California.
No, she owns.
I understand. Well, do you get into the city very often?
First time in 2 years.
Really? How did you find it?
My daughter drove.
Well, no, how do you find the city in 2 years since you've been here?
Not by New York.
I suppose not. Well, listen, I'm really very excited about all this. For that matter, everyone in the industry is.
Well, we'll see.
How we doing, Uncle Willie? The water's not boiling yet.
Oh, I see.
Well, listen, I'd like to have a car come pick you up and take you home after you're done rehearsing.
But no, my daughter's gonna pick me up.
That's right. What time did you say she was coming for? 5 o'clock?
She's gonna call me every hour.
One tea or two tea?
Uncle Willie. Well, I guess it's been a long time since you two actually...
One tea or two tea?
Well, none for me, Uncle Willie. I'm about to be leaving. Mr. Lewis, would you like some tea?
Yes, thank you. I'd love it.
One tea, Uncle Willie.
Sure, I got two balls. I can dunk twice.
You know, honestly, the good tea is fine. Here's your tea, Mr. Lewis. Well, listen, is there anything on your mind or anything I can help you out with? Any questions, like about the studio or the rehearsal or the air date?
Like what?
Well, the studio or the rehearsal or the air date.
You got props.
Well, what props?
For the doctor's guest, you gotta have the props.
Oh, certainly. Why don't you tell me what you need and I'll make sure they get it.
All right. You need a desk, a telephone,
what do we, okay.
A blackboard. A piece of white chalk, piece of red chalk,
okay.
Skeleton, not too tall. Let's see, stethoscope, thermometer, awe stick.
An awe stick, what's an awe stick?
Well, a stick, you would say ah.
An awe stick.
A look stick, bottle of pills.
A look stick, what's a look stick?
Look stick, look in the air, they got a little piece of cotton.
Right, a look stick.
Bottle of pills, for, like for a horse.
Well, not like this?
No, that's for a pony, like this. cotton, bandages.
Wait a minute, you're going a little too fast.
A desk.
I got all that. The last thing I got was a cotton balls and an eye chart.
A man suit like this one, size 40.
Also in brown, blue.
What do I need? Two blue shoes. Get a brown.
Right. All right.
A piece of liver.
And a piece of liver.
Well, what kind of liver?
Irish calf liver, you know, from the butcher shop.
Well, how much? Like a pound?
A little laugh's a pound. A big laugh is 2 pounds. 3 pounds with a lot of blood on it and bring the house down.
All right, that's it?
That's it. Oh, plus a blonde.
You mean a woman?
Who wants a blonde nurse who's a man? Get a big one. I mean, as big as you can get. You know, bust size 40, 45, and a nice bottom.
So a sexy girl with a full round rear end.
You know, but, you know, that's too big. Perfect.
I know what you mean.
Well, listen, why don't you give me some picture and I'll pick one.
There's a million girls like that around. Yeah.
One we had was the best one. I'd call her, but she's maybe 80, 85.
That's all right, I'll take the girl. All right, anything else?
That's it for me. Uncle Willie?
I wasn't listening.
All right. Well, if you guys can think of anything, just give me a call. That's 11:15. I gotta get going. I'm leaving, Uncle Willie. Mr. Lewis, I just want to say thank you on behalf of all the young people who never got a chance to see you guys perform. Thank you. To the both of you. To the both of you, Uncle Willie.
I hope they're not disappointed.
Oh, they won't be.
I know what I'm just
saying. Uncle Willie, I'm leaving.
I'll walk you to the elevator.
It's not necessary. Listen, I just want to say what a happy moment this is for me. To see the two of you together again, reunited. The two kings of comedy. This must be very exciting for both of you, isn't it? Well, we're off to a great start. I'll call you tonight.
Circulates just fine. I'm not saying it circulates everywhere, but it circulates.
Is that why you use a cane?
Not a cane, it's a walking stick. Maybe once in a great while it's a cane.
Thank God. I've been real lucky I'm in the pink.
Yeah, I was looking. I thought maybe you had a flush there for a minute.
Saul Burton died.
Go on. Who's Saul Burton?
You don't remember Saul Burton?
Oh, manager from the Belasco.
That was Saul Bernstein.
No, not Saul Bernstein. Saul Burton was the manager from Belasco.
Saul Bernstein was the manager from Belasco. And it wasn't the Belasco, it was the Marasco.
Sid Weinstein. Saul Burton was the manager from the Belasco. Saul Bernstein, I don't know who the hell he was.
How do you remember anything if your blood don't circulate?
My blood circulation in my head. Just no
coming down?
Wait a minute. Wasn't Sid Weinstein the songwriter?
For Christ's sake, Saul Bertram was the songwriter, so I'm trying to tell you.
Who wrote that?
Lady, Lady, Be
That's Mine. Right, Saul Bertram, the lousy songwriter. That's what I tried to tell you. That Saul Bertram.
That guy, Saul Bertram. He died?
Last week.
Where?
In Variety.
How is Saul Bernstein?
I didn't read anything.
Good. Yeah. I always like Saul Bernstein. So this is where you live now, huh?
Well, isn't this where I always live?
No, not here. You lived in the big suite.
This is the big suite, now it's five small suites.
Well, isn't that the way today? Anything to squeeze it off. What do you pay for the small suite?
Same thing as the big suite.
I have a nice room with my daughter in New Jersey. Got my own bathroom. I don't bother them, they don't bother me.
Is it in the country?
Certainly it's in the country. Where do you think New Jersey is?
New Jersey's what I see from a park bench. Is it a private house?
Oh, certainly it's a private house. Is it big? It's got 3/4 of an acre. Got their own trees, their own bushes. Got nice little swimming pool for the kids they blow up in the summertime. Big swing in the backyard. And a nice little dog house. What? A rock garden.
Like for rocks?
You never saw a rock garden?
Not that anxious.
Beautiful. Kind of invaded. Here. You'll take a bus out to New Jersey and I'll show it to you sometime.
I want to take a bus all the way to New Jersey to see a rock garden.
You don't even know what I'm talking about. You have to live in the country to appreciate it. I mean, I didn't think it was possible. I'd be so happy out there in the country.
You don't mind all that quiet?
They got noise in New Jersey. A quiet noise, birds, drizzle. I mean, not like here with the buzzing.
You see, that's where we're different. You like the country because you're retired. You can sit on a porch and look at a tree, watch a bush grow. And me, I'm still very active. We have a different temperament. You're a slow person.
All right, slow person?
I'm a slow person. You've been here 15 minutes. You're still working on the same cup of tea.
That's
I can
right.
Get more, and I can get more even.
You finished your tea, I am still enjoying my tea. That's always been the difference between you and me.
That's where you're wrong. That's where you're wrong. You know, I'm still very active. You know, I keep you going. I like a busy life. I have to keep busy. That's why I like that city so much. I got to be near a telephone. You never know when a picture's going to come up, a musical, a commercial.
When did you do a picture?
Huh?
I say, when did you do a picture?
They're negotiating.
When did you do a musical?
They're talking.
And when did you do a commercial?
All the time. Did one last week.
For what?
A potato chip.
What potato chips?
Potato chip. The big one, you know, crispy. Potato chip, you know.
What do I know? I don't eat potato chips.
The hell's the difference what the name of it is anyway?
They hire you to do a potato chip commercial and you can't remember the name.
You remember Saul Bertram?
I'm not selling Saul Bertram.
I don't want to argue with you.
Well, I didn't come all the way from New Jersey to argue with you either.
So what do you think? So you want to do the doctor's sketch or what?
Oh, you're not a guest, Bertram.
You want to do the doctor's sketch? You want to do it?
Good money. A few days' work, be back in New Jersey in no time. I feel, if you feel that you'd like to do it, then my feeling is I'm available.
And my feeling, they told you.
What?
They didn't tell you my feeling is I'm against it.
You're against it?
I'm against it, but I'll do it if you want.
Well, I don't want you to do it if you're against it. You're against it, don't do it.
What the hell's the difference if I'm against it as long as I'm doing it? I just want you to know why I'm doing it.
Favor.
I'm not doing you any favors. I'm doing my nephew a favor. It'd be very good for him in the business as an agent if we do it.
You sure?
I'm positive. I'd be a feather in his cap and get a couple of big stars like us.
Well, that's different. In that case, I'm against it too, but I'll do it.
As long as we understand each other.
I just want to make sure you know something. I'm not doing it for the money. That money goes to my grandkids.
The whole thing?
The whole thing. Not now. Only if I die. You
know? That's the same with me.
You don't have any grandchildren.
They're my nephew's children, Cynthia and...
Oh, very good.
So, shall we rehearse the sketch?
You're not against rehearsing.
No, I'm just against doing it. I'm not good at rehearsing, and it's important.
All right, let's rehearse. Let's move the furniture around and make the set.
Chiropractic sketch that we did.
You're positive?
I'm more than positive, I'm sure.
Show me the doctor's sketch.
Just trying to make it a halfway intelligent question.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I usually ask the kind of questions of the kind of person I'm talking to. You know, my dear.
I get you, good, mister.
All right. Skip the nurse part. I'll start where I come in.
Okay, from where you come in.
All right.
Go outside.
I'm outside.
Okay.
Knock, knock, knock. Hello, I came to see the doctor.
You're not outside.
I'm outside.
You were outside, could you see?
No.
Could you see?
Yes.
Then you're not outside. Go all the way outside. What the hell kind of rehearsal is this?
It's a rehearsing rehearsal.
Can't you make believe I'm all the way out in the hall?
I can make believe you're still in New Jersey, but you're not. You're here. We don't got a nurse, but we got a door in the shoe, so we go kind of let's try to have a professional rehearsal.
Listen, we're not going to stop for every little thing, are we? I mean, I don't know how many years I got left. I don't want to spend them rehearsing.
Stop for
the
little things, but big thing. And the door's a big thing.
I'm going to the door, and I'll come back in. We'll run the sketch once or twice, and that'll be it for today, all right?
All right, that's another big thing.
All right, I'm going out. I'll be right back.
Okay.
If my doctor calls, if my daughter calls before I come out, you tell her to pick me up in an hour.
Well, she picked you up now for all I care. All right, knock, knock, knock.
Knock, knock, knock.
Don't say it, for Christ's sake, do it! You went crazy in the country. All right, come in.
Won't open.
Oh. Wait a minute. It's not locked.
It's not locked?
No, it's not locked. It's locked.
Let's call down that Sandy boy. He'll come up here and come up here. Let me try again.
No, God damn it. You're just wasting time. The Sandy boy, go down to town and come up.
I fixed it.
Yeah. You just don't know how to open the door. Never mind the damn door.
Did my daughter call?
You know, I think you went crazy in the country.
Are you going to stand there and insult me? Are we going to rehearse this sketch?
I'd like to do them both, but we don't have time. Just stand there. Never mind the damn door. Just stand there and say, knock, knock, knock.
I hope I can get back out.
Oh, God, so do I.
Knock, knock, knock. Knock, knock, knock.
Enter!
What do you mean, enter? What happened to come in?
Oh, say, hang in or come in, what the
The difference is we've done this sketch 3,000 times, and you've always said, come in. Suddenly today is enter. Why, after all these years, it changed it to enter?
I'm just trying to freshen up the act, that's all.
Who asked me to freshen up the act? They asked for the doctor's sketch, didn't they? The doctor said start with come in, not enter. You want to freshen things up, put some flowers in here.
This new generation, this ain't 1935, you know.
Oh, no kidding. I didn't read the paper today.
What in the hell's the difference? Enter, come in, as long as you're in.
Because it's different. You know why we did it the same way for 30, 43 years? But it's good.
And you know why we don't do it anymore? Because we did it the same way for 43 years. That's why.
If we're not doing it anymore, why are we changing it?
Listen, I'd like to make a comment here. Here, sit down. This is nothing personal. But I think you've been sitting on the porch in New Jersey too long.
What does that mean?
It means I think you've been sitting on the porch in New Jersey too long. You know, from my window, I see everything go on in this world. I see old people, I see young people, I see bad people, good people, I see people jumping off buildings, I see drug addicts, I see people peeing on the sidewalk, I see everything. You see a lawnmower and a mailbox.
And that's why you want to say enter instead of come in?
Are you listening to me?
Well, is there anybody else in the room?
You know, you don't have any idea what's going on in this world today.
Oh, really? What's going on in the world today?
Have you ever heard the expression, that's where it's at? Well, this is where it's at, and this is where I'm
You ever hear the expression, you don't know what the hell you're talking about? Just before the other expression, you never knew what the hell you were talking about.
You know, I wasn't the one who retired. You retired, I'll tell you why you retired, because you're getting old. You're getting old-fashioned. Well, not me. Not me, I'm new. I'm new-fashioned, and I'll always be fashioned. Brand new.
Oh, I see. That's why you're in such demand today. That's why you're such a hot property, huh? That's why you do movies you don't do. That's why you do music because you're not in. And that's why you do commercials you can't make because you can't remember to make them.
You know what I do remember? I remember what a pain in the ass you were to work with. That's what I remember.
That's why. And when you were with this pain in the ass, you lived in a 5-room suite. Now you live in a 1-room suite. And you're wearing the same goddamn pajamas you wore in the 5-room suite.
I don't want to argue with you. When you say enter, when you say knock, knock, I'm going to say enter. And you say knock, knock, I say enter. If you don't want to come in, don't come in.
You can't say nothing without my permission. I own 50% of this act.
Yeah, well, you say what you want for your 50% for my 50%. I'm going to say enter.
When I say knock, knock, if you say enter, I'm coming in all right, but not at all, I'm coming in with a lawyer.
From New Jersey, you'd be lucky if you bring a cow.
In Brooklyn.
God, shit, you're giving me the finger.
You know something? You're crazy.
You're crazy. One more time. Say goodbye to me. I'm crazy. You say I'm crazy? I'm crazy? I may be crazy, but you're senile. You know what that means?
I'm not giving you any straight line.
Crazy when you're missing a few parts. Senile is when you got the hell out of the business. That's you, mister.
Hello.
Is that my daughter?
Hello.
Is that her?
Shut up! Will you shut up for 5 minutes? Could you use a behavior? Can't you see I'm on the phone with the person? Just be quiet.
Hello.
It's your daughter.
Hello, sweetheart. Look, I can't talk now. I said I can't.
I can't.
Because you're the crazy bedbug, that's why.
Bedbug's all right, mister's no good.
Your father's sick. Come and get your sick father.
Shut up! Can you see I'm talking to a person? For God's sake, be quiet. I want you to pick me up now. I don't want to talk about it. Pick me up now in front of the hotel. Don't get too close. It's filthy here. I know what I promised. Don't argue with me. Pick me up in front. I'll probably get mugged. She wants to talk to you.
Who is it?
Eleanor Roosevelt.
What do you mean, who is it? You tell me it's my daughter?
I know it's your daughter. I forgot her name.
Doris.
What does she want?
Am I Doris? She'll tell you.
Hello, this is Willie Clark,
darling.
Unpleasantness?
Oh, no, no. There's no unpleasantness here. Stupidity, maybe, but no
unpleasantness. Tell her I put my coat on. I got one sleeve in.
Yeah, I know. I was hoping to work out, too, honey, but, I mean, I bent over backward and forward. He didn't even bend sideways.
Tell her I got the other sleeve in. I'm headed for the door. I got my hat.
Of one word, honey, enter. That's it. It comes down to enter. That's it.
The hat is on. Tell her. Come out the door.
I'll tell her. Thank you, Dorothy. I told her we'd give her one more chance.
Not if you say enter. Come in, I'll stay. Enter. I go.
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
Don't fool around with me. You're going to say come in.
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
I know you, you bastard.
Ask me knock, knock, knock.
Knock, knock, knock. Why are you enter? You enter.
Diane? Diane?
Yes, Phil?
Any chance of doing this today?
Yeah, we're already done here, Phil.
We're just waiting on the actors.
Well, what the hell is happening?
I don't know. There's a problem with the makeup. Mr. Clark wants a number 7 Amber or something.
Well, then get it for him.
Where? They stopped making it 34 years ago.
Christ.
Mr. Lewis says the Austics are too short.
The what?
The Austics. Don't ask me. I'm still trying to figure out what a look stick is.
What the hell are we making here, Nicholas and Alexandra? Tell them this is just a dress rehearsal. We'll worry about the props later. Let's just get moving.
Okay, we got it.
Mr. Schaefer, sorry for the delay. Mr. Lewis and Mr. Clark have had some technical problems backstage.
Yeah, well, we've had it all week. I'm afraid we're running out of time here. I've got 12 other goddamn numbers to get through today.
Yeah, okay, no problem. There's no problem at all.
Tell them I want to run straight through, no stopping. They can clean up whatever they want afterwards.
Right, I'll get them right out. They're straight on. They're ready now. I'll tell them straight through, no stopping. They're ready now. Thank you.
Diane?
Yeah, Phil?
Let's run it from the top with a voiceover.
Okay, we got it.
Voiceover.
The golden age of comedy reaches zenith during a fabulous and glorious era known as vaudeville. Fanny Bryce, W.C. Fields, Eddie Cantor, Ed Wynn, Will Rogers, and a host of other greats fill its Hall of Fame. There are two other names that belong in this list, but they can never be listed separately. They are more than a team. They are two comic shining lights that beam as one. For Lewis without Clark is like laughter without joy. When these two greats retired, a comic style disappeared from the American scene that will never see its like again. Here then, in a sketch tape nearly 11 years ago on the Ed Sullivan Show, are Lewis and Clark in their classic scene, The Doctor Will See You Now.
Doctor sketch.
Oh, we're not doing that.
You have to do it. It's in the contract. That's what you're getting paid to do, the doctor sketch.
Well, we're not doing it.
Why not?
I don't know. It's, we got all messed up. He doesn't remember the lines. And he's out of shape.
I'm out of shape?
Yeah, you're out of shape. Once we didn't get the lines, we rehearsed it. You were, you forgot it, and your English accent's gone.
There's nothing wrong with my English accent. Hello, I'd like to see the doctor.
Oh, that's an English accent. Yeah. You sound like Bert and Mary Poppins.
Mary
Poppins! Oh, yes, I'm sorry, hold up the rehearsal. We got a problem here. This man is a lunatic.
Hold it, stop.
I'm going to tell you something I never told you in my entire life. I hate your guts.
You told me that on Monday.
Listen, gentlemen, I really don't see the point going on with this rehearsal.
Well, I don't see any point in doing this show. This man is persecuting me. He's been doing it for 11 years, and I'm not going to give him a chance.
I knew it. I've been waiting 11 years just to walk out on me just like that.
I didn't want to do it in the first place.
Liar. You liar. His daughter begged me. Some daughter begged me on the telephone.
The man's hysterical. You see that for yourself.
I don't need you. I never need you. You're not the one that's on your death and now.
He pulled a knife on me. This man pulled a knife on me in his own apartment.
Maybe his career.
Crazy.
But not mine. Maybe your career is over, but not mine. You asshole. I never said
I'm taking a touchdown.
I don't need a doctor, don't judge
us. Don't
let anybody see my pinky.
Frito-Lay, is that true?
Let's sing it together.
Hello's host, Miss Lee. I'm with us on today.
What time is it?
10 to 1.
Who are you?
Don't give me that. You know who I am.
Are you the same nurse as yesterday?
I'm the same nurse from every day for 2 weeks now. Don't play your games with me.
I can't even chew a piece of bread. I'm not going to play games. Why'd you turn on television?
It's either watching that or watching you sleep. Either one ain't too interesting.
Sorry, I've got to sleep more entertaining. What is it? What is this, Tuesday?
Wednesday.
How could it be Wednesday? I went to sleep on Monday.
But haven't we seen Mike Douglas twice this week?
Once.
Twice.
All right, twice. Good. I was all right yesterday?
Oh, we are doing very well.
We are. When did you get sick?
That's funny. That's really funny, Mr. Clark. Soon as I get home tonight, I'm gonna bust out laughing.
Well, you keep eating that candy, you're gonna bust out sooner than that.
And there's no sense in throwing it out. I'm just storing up energy for the winter.
You know, it made me find time between the peppermint and the nugget to take my pulse.
I did it. It's a little better today.
When did you take my pulse?
When you were sleeping.
Well, everybody's pulse is good when you sleep. You gotta take a person's pulse when they're awake. I don't tell you the truth, I don't really think you know what the hell you're doing. I'm not a prejudiced person.
But I am. And I don't like sick people who tell registered nurses how to do their job. You want your tea now?
I don't want to interrupt the candy.
And don't get fresh with me. You can get fresh with your nephew, but you can't get fresh with me. I mean, maybe he has to take it, but I'm not a blood relative.
That's for sure.
That's even funnier than the other one. Oh, my whole evening's going to be taken up tonight with nothing but laughing.
I don't even eat candy. Eat the whole box, then when you do, you eat the flowers.
Do you know why I don't get angry at anything you say to me?
I give up. Why?
Because I have a good sense of humor. No, I am known for my good sense of humor. That's why I can take anything you say to me.
But if your nurse is good as your sense of humor, I won't make it till Thursday. Who called?
No one.
I thought I heard a telephone.
No one called. Did you have a nice nap?
It was a nap, nothing special. Would you not do that? Well, don't puff up my pillows. You know, I spend all day and I try to get them the way I like them, and you puff them all up.
Woke up a little grouchy, didn't we?
I wish you quit making yourself a partner all the time. I woke up. Don't make the bed, I'm in it. Don't make the person's bed while we're still in it.
You can't stand to have people do things for you, can you? You know, if you just want someone to sit here and watch you, you're better off getting a dog, Mr. Clark. I suggest that to your nephew.
I'm not gonna tell you, I'm just asking for a couple of things. Don't take my pulse while I'm asleep. Don't make the bed while I'm in it. And do it the other way around, we're in business.
Yeah.
How old is a woman like you?
That is none of your business.
I'm not asking for business.
I'm 45 years young.
You married?
My husband passed away 4 years ago.
You were the nurse? Slippers.
Not worried about your slippers. And don't play on my sympathy. I don't have any. And I'm not expecting any coming in the near future.
How about a nice alcohol rub?
I just gave you one.
No, I give you one.
You know, I know you just say things like that to agitate me. You like to agitate people, don't you? Well, I am not an agitated person.
You're right, I'd be better off with a dog.
How did your poor wife stand a man like you?
Who told you about my poor wife?
Your poor nephew. Did you ever think of getting married again?
Is that a proposal?
Not from me. I am not thinking of getting married again. Besides, you're just not my type.
Is it a question of religion?
It's a question of age. You'd wear me out in no time.
You think I can't support you? I got Medicare.
You never explained.
Of course, Tom, I won't be here.
Well, that's where you're going to be unless you learn to slow up a little.
Slow up? I moved 2 inches in 3 weeks.
I mean, if you're considering getting well again, you're going to have to stop worrying about the telephone calls and the messages, and especially when you're going back to work.
I'm an actor. God, actors is my profession.
Your profession right now is being a sick person. And if you're going to act anywhere, it's going to be from a sick bed.
Maybe I can get a job on a hospital show.
You know, you can turn everything I say into a vocal routine if you want. But I'm going to give you a piece of advice, Mr. Clark.
What's that?
The world is full of sick people. And there just ain't enough doctors or nurses to go around to take care of all the sick people. And all the doctors and all the nurses, they can only do so much, Mr. Clark. But God, in his infinite wisdom, has said that he will help those who help themselves.
So what's the advice?
Stop bugging me!
Stop bugging you, whatever that means.
That's better. I hear my pipe again.
There comes today's candy.
Oh, fine. I think we're going to get married.
Uncle Willie, you look terrific.
You got my variety?
We had about 200 get-well telegrams for about every star in show business. Lucille Ball, Milton Berle, Bob Hope, the mayor.
You hear commercials, you hear anything about the saucer?
We got plenty of time to talk about that. Miss Okoye, have you had your lunch yet today?
Oh, no, not yet.
She had about 2 pounds of appetizer.
Why don't you go out and take an hour, so I'll be here for a while.
Oh, thank you. I could use some fresh air. Now, when I'm gone, I don't want you getting all agitated again. You hear?
I hear. Stop bugging me.
And don't get up to go to the bathroom. Choose the you-know-what.
If I don't, I'll go you-know-where.
Never mind. She's a very good nurse.
You got any cigars?
You realize you've had a heart attack, don't you? I mean, you've been getting away with it for years, the cigars, the corned beef sandwiches, the tension, the temper tantrums. You can't do anymore, Uncle Willie. Your heart's not going to take it.
So this is the great news you rushed up here to give me? Gonna miss the Wednesday.
I talked to the doctor this morning. And well, I'm going to have to be very frank and honest with you, Uncle Willie. You're going to have to retire. Give it up. Show business is out.
Till when?
Until ever. Your blood pressure's abnormally high. Your heart is weak. If you try to work again, you kill yourself.
I'm going to have to think it over.
Think it over? Think what over? There's nothing to think over. There's no decision to be made.
You decide for Ben Silverman. I'll decide for Willie Clark.
No, okay? I'll decide for Willie Clark. I'm your closest and only living relative, and I'm responsible for your well-being. You can't live here anymore, Willie, not alone. And I can't afford to keep this nurse on permanently. She's making more than I am. Besides, she's already given her notice. She's leaving Monday. She's going to Buffalo to work for a very wealthy family.
Maybe she should take me with her. I always did well in Buffalo.
Face the facts, Willie. We got to do something and do it quickly.
I can't think about it. I'm tired. I'm going to take a nap.
You want to hear my suggestion?
I'm napping. Don't you see my eyes? This is a nap.
I'd like you to move in with me and Helen and the kids. We have a small bedroom in the back. I think you'd be very comfortable. Are you listening, Uncle Willie?
What's the second suggestion?
What's the matter with the first?
Not as good as the second.
I haven't made any yet.
Still better than the first.
Why?
Forget it. I don't like kids. They're noisy. A little bit hit me with a baseball bat.
I've also seen you sit and talk to them for hours on end about vaudeville and have the time of your life, right?
And if I stop talking to them, it was a baseball. Just get it. No offense, but I'm not living with your kids. Get rid of them, we'll talk.
See, I know what this is about. It's because Al Lewis lives with his family, and you're trying to prove some stupid point about being independent.
What's the second suggestion?
All right. Now, don't jump when I say this, because it's not as bad as it sounds.
Say it.
There's the actor's home in New Brunswick.
Get
God, this is bad as it sounds.
You're wrong. I drove out there last Sunday. They showed me around the whole place. I couldn't believe how beautiful it was.
You drove all the way out there without asking me to live with you, Kurt?
Just to investigate, that's all. There's no commitments.
The old actor's home. First job you got me in 10 years.
It's on a lake. It's got 25 acres of beautiful grounds. It's an old converted mansion. It's got this porch that wraps around the
entire... Oh my God, you got me on the front porch in New Jersey. He put you up to this, didn't he?
You don't have to sit on the porch. There's a million activities for you to do there. They do a show every Friday and Saturday night. I mean, it's a bunch of old actors. What could be better for you?
Oh, I knew Jersey. I hate New Jersey. We should have never finished the George Washington Bridge.
I couldn't believe how many actors were there. I still remember. I know they were all dead.
Well, that's some recommendation. Home in the swamps with forgotten people.
They're not forgotten. They're very well taken care of. Uncle Willie, I promise you, if you spend one day there that you're not happy, you can come back and move in with me.
So that's my choice, New Jersey or the baseball bat?
Well, I feel a lot better about everything.
What about you?
What do you mean, what about me?
Well, I go see you no more?
Of course you'll see me. As often as I can. Did you think I wouldn't come and visit you, Uncle Willie?
People won't go to New Jersey unless they have to.
I'll be there every Wednesday with a variety. I'll even bring Helen and the kids.
Don't bring the kids. For Christ's sake, what do they got going to home?
You know, this is the first time you've treated me like a nephew and not like an agent. It's a whole new relationship for us.
Hope it works out better than the other one.
I've been waiting for this for 15 years. You just would never let me get close, Uncle Willie.
Kiss me, I'll call the whole thing off.
No kiss. I promise. Now, there's just one more thing I'd like you to do for me.
God, my luck, it's a benefit.
In a way, it's a benefit. For not for any organization, it's for another human being.
What are you talking about?
Al Lewis wants to see you.
Oh my God. If you want to kill me, why don't you just bring a cigar?
He's been heartsick ever since this happened.
He's heartsick? What do you mean, this is the mumps?
You know what I mean? He calls me 2 times a day to see how you are. He's worried to death.
Tonight tell him I'm worse.
He's not more himself. He's got diabetes. He's got hardening of the arteries. His eyes are getting very bad.
He sees good enough to spit in my face.
He's lost 7 pounds since you've been in the hospital. Who do you think's been sending you all these flowers and candy? He's got to keep writing other people's names on the card, otherwise you know you throw them out.
Throw them out. They're hit flowers and throw them out.
Uncle Willie, I've never asked you to do anything for me as long as I've known you. But this is important. For me. For you. For Al Lewis. He won't even stay. He just wants to say hello.
Say hello, huh?
That's it.
All right, if he wants to come up and just say hello and apologize to me, I won't stop him, but I may be taking a nap.
Give us all a break, Uncle Willie. I knew I could count on you. He's going to be very happy. Yes, could you tell the boy at the front desk to send Mr. Lewis up to Mr. Clark's room? Thank you.
He's here? In the hotel now?
Well, I knew it would be all right. Now, just promise me you'll be decent to Al Lewis.
Well, I'll be wonderful to him. I'll leave him you in my will.
What are you doing?
I'm not going to let him sit in bed like a sick person. I'm going to get up and look better than him.
The doctor said you're not supposed to get out of bed for anything.
Okay, that's the chair. Move the chair all the way back there. I want him to have a long walk. I'm going to tell the fellas. Al, make it too, but tell us. I'll look down.
This is the last time. I am never butting in your guys' lives again.
Oh, God. This is worth having a heart attack for. Knock again. Anna!
No, it's all right. He's just dozing. Can I take your hat?
No, thank you. I've something to hang on to.
Uncle Willie, there's someone here to see you. Look who's here to see you, Uncle Willie.
I'm sorry. I don't have my glasses on. Who is it?
It's me, Willie. Al. Al Lewis.
Al Lewis. I can't see it. Oh, you're so far away. Come over here. Oh,
interesting.
Yeah, sorry. I'm just reading all my telegrams from Bob Hope and Lucille Ball.
Oh, that's nice. And look at all the beautiful flowers.
Yeah, I'm throwing them out. I don't like to smell. Keep sending them to me along with cheap candy, you know. I guess they mean well.
Yeah, certainly do. Well, I just wanted to drop up and say, see how you're doing. I don't want to take up your time. No. Just want to say hello. So, hello, goodbye.
Now, wait a minute. Maybe I got a while for my next nap. Sit down here. We'll talk a while.
You sure? It's okay.
Sure. You got a lot more to say than just hello. You want some tea?
I'd love some tea. Yeah.
Go in there to the kitchen and make it.
I got a better idea. Why don't I go down to the kitchen and have him send up a tray? If I call room service, it's going to take forever.
Don't you want to hear what Al has to say?
I don't think it's necessary. It'll just be 10 minutes. Mr. Lewis, it's good to see you. It's good to see the both of you.
Nice boy.
He's the best. Not too bright, but he's a good boy.
Got everything you need in here?
Well, what do I need?
Books, magazines, maybe?
Oh, no, I got plenty to do this answering all my fan mail.
You get fan mail?
Oh, yeah, don't you?
Sure you do. You sure it's all right you to be talking like this?
I'm not talking. I'm answering. You're talking. Is there something special you want to say?
Like what?
Not what's on your mind. I don't know why you can't sleep at night.
I sleep beautifully.
Are you sure? You look a little puny, a little peaked, like, you know, something. You might have something on your conscience.
I have nothing on my conscience at all.
And you look good.
I have nothing on my conscience. I mean, I just feel bad because you're sick, that's all.
Thank you. I accept your apology.
No apology. I meant no apology. I just said, I'm sorry you're sick.
Well, who do you think made me sick?
Who? You did, that's who, not me. You carried on like a lunatic, screaming and yelling. You made yourself sick. And for that, I'm sorry.
Well, I'm glad you're sorry for something.
I'm sorry for the people starving in India, but I'm not going to apologize for it. I didn't do it.
I didn't accuse you of India. I just said you come up here to apologize to me, and I'm a gentleman enough to have accepted it.
I knew there was going to be trouble when you said enter instead of come.
No trouble. You came up, you apologized, you got what it was, and now I'm happy.
What you got? You got no apology from me, which you didn't accept.
Don't argue with me. I had a heart attack.
You know something, Willie? I don't think we get along too good.
Well, everybody has their ups and downs.
In 43 years, maybe one up. Tell you the truth, Willie, I can't take the downs anymore.
To be honest with you, I'm a little tired myself. In a way, I'm glad I had this heart attack. I think I needed to rest.
What are you going to do now?
My nephew gave me 2 pretty good offers.
Is that so?
Yeah, I think I'll probably take the second one.
Are you in any condition to work again?
Maybe a show Saturday night, something like that.
In New York?
No, be out of town.
Well, that's not before.
So what about you? What are you going to
do? Oh, very happy. My daughter's having another baby. Because they're going to be needing my room. You know, I don't want to be a burden to them. So we talked it over. I'm going to move to the actor's home over in New Brunswick. You took the jokes too seriously. I mean, they were just jokes. For 43 years, we did an act, and I don't think you ever enjoyed it.
If it's there to enjoy it, I'd have bought a ticket.
Well, look, maybe you can enjoy it now. If you got some time, why don't you come over to the Adler Zone and visit me?
You can count on it.
I feel a lot better we talk now. Look, what, maybe you like to rest. We'll take a little nap, okay? Yeah,
I am kind of tired. Just keep talking and probably fall asleep a little bit.
What's new in Variety?
Bernie Einstein died.
Oh, go on. House manager at the palace.
No, that was Sam Heisel. Bernie Einstein was dancing Ramon and Rodriguez.
Jackie Arison was Ramon and Rodriguez. Bernie Einstein was the house doctor when we first played with Sophie Tucker.
No, no, I don't want me. I'm sick.
I know, but why should I be sick too? And remember when Meyer and Cohen played with Sophie Tucker? Oh. We opened for him. Oh. Milton Berle was a kid. Oh.